Hi everyone, hope you're okay and you're keeping busy and you're looking forward to playing some guitar with these videos. This is for year 5 and 6, a revise of what we've been playing, and some of the year 4s have played these songs as well, so you'll know who you are if you can play these. So watch the video. We start off with Dance Monkey Capo 2, and remember, we're leaving out a fret again, and it's got a pattern in it, and it's going to go E minor, all the strings, C, D, B minor, 1, 2 and 3 there. So it's the same pattern all the way through, and we're leaving 4 beats between each to begin with till we get to the chorus. So it's just 1, 2, 3, 4, C, 2, 3, 4, D, 2, 3, 4, B minor. Okay, now when we get to the chorus, then we'll go 4 strums on each, C, D, B minor, or if you'd like another strumming pattern, we could use our down, down,
three, four.
you enjoyed that. So keep your fingers pushed forward, make sure they don't lean across the strings and press quite hard, and then you get a better sound. Well done, everybody. Okay, our next song is going to be Living on a Prayer. If you can get that one ready. Right, hello again, everybody. We're going to play Living on a Prayer. No capo for this one. And remember, the intro was 16 E minors, 4 C's, 4 D's, 8 E minors, 4 C's, 4 D's, and then you come in with the verse. Okay, Tommy used to work on the docks. And everyone's singing this one. I'll just put my glasses on, then I can see you better. You might have seen these already. Are we ready? Okay, everybody, I'll do the bass part while you're doing the chords, okay? So don't copy off me for the beginning bit, and I'll join in with the chorus. I'll play the bass. You're gonna do 16 E minors, 4 C's, 4 D's, 8 E minors, 4 C's, 4 D's. Ready? When the drum roll comes in, you start. Because after this it changes key and it goes higher, so our chords will change and we need some bar chords that we haven't done yet. But well done, everybody. Now with the bridge, if you found the bridge a little bit hard, it was she says we've got to hold C for two, D for two, on to one, wave E minor two. So it's C for two, we've got a hold, D for four, sorry, on, two, one, leave, E minor two, then again C2 on the next line, D4, E minor 2, and the same on the next line. So it goes, she says we've got a hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We've got each other, and that's a lot for love. Then we like this bit. We'll give it a shot. On the chorus, it's E minor 2. Speed in the lesson, I've usually just played it, we've sang along, so we played it then to Bon Jovi. And if you found it a bit hard, just go over the bridge without them singing it, just till you get used to those changes, because it is fast. Don't be put off by it, because if you turn it off and try it on its own, you will be able to do it if you go over it a few times. Okay, I have seen evidence of that in the lessons, quite a few of you have tried this bit and could do it definitely by the end of the lesson or the week after. So great stuff. Okay, our next song, I think we'll go to A Million Dreams, and we'll do the finger picking if you want to get that one ready. Again, we don't need a capo. Okay, A Million Dreams. So if you end up trying to play A Million Dreams, the finger picking with the song, it is very fast. So if you can't do it, you can slow it down to 75% on the settings. But even I think at the normal speed, you might find it a little bit hard. It will take quite a lot of practice. So don't worry if you can't do it. As long as you can get the sound in your own speed, your own pace, that's great. It makes a really lovely sound, the finger picking. So we put our finger 2 on the 5th fret, okay, on the 4th string, that's the bottom metal string, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Those are the strings. The 6 one's the thick one at the top. And second finger on the 5th fret, and you're going to pluck the second string, so that's not the bottom nylon one, the second one up, and we do that 4 times, thumb and finger, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, do you remember, we slide to the 2nd fret, add your first finger on where number 3 purple is, your first finger, that's on fret 3, second string up. And we pluck those 2 that we're pressing 4 times. And then we put our first finger on the blue, 1, the top finger for A7, and our third finger on the 3rd fret, number 3, purple, or the 3rd fret, 2nd string up. And we pluck that 4 times. And then put your 2nd finger in the 3rd fret, 5th string, and you pluck those 2. Remember to change now your thumb to this one. 2, 3, 4. So I'll play them. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that comes in as the intro and through the first verse. So if you wanted to play it yourself without the backing track, that'd be great, singing it, and you could just play this. Close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. So you can do it your own speed. They can say it all sounds crazy, You have a chord sheet though, should have a chord sheet with all these on. So fingers two and three like that and little C on. Five strings for A minor and leave the B. I'll do the B, it's a bar chord. Okay. And then the finger picking comes in at the end of the chorus. There's a house we can build. So you could do this for verse one and verse two instead of strumming it. If you don't want to finger pick it, just strum it like this. I close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me. And that's what we probably will do when we play along with them, because it is very fast. So we'll strum the chords, but you could try the finger picking on your own. Or if you've got some friends, go on FaceTime, whatever you go on, and one of your friends could play finger picking while you do the chords. And you could get a band going, a group, who knows. So here we go, we'll play it. So we'll strum it for now. Close my eyes and I can see the world is waiting for me that I call.
Yeah.
Great, okay. Well done, everybody. So, maybe a bit faster than what you've been going if you've been singing on your own, but that's fine. It's nice to sing on your own. Some of you have been very, very proud of what you've played with the notes when you've played that for me. And I think it's really boosted your confidence. So keep going with that one. You do sound lovely playing that. That's one of our latest ones, the finger picking at the end of the term. So keep on it. Well done. So our next one, I think, shall we do Castle on a Hill? And you need capo 7 on Castle on a Hill. So if you get that one ready, and capo 7. Hello everyone again. We're going to do Castles on a Hill by Ed Sheeran, and our capo 7's on. Get that one on, and it's G, C, E minor, D. G, C, E minor, D. Over and over those chords, 4 times through. Okay, we'll try that bit first. G, C, E minor, then D, and then G, C, E minor, then D. Okay, just watch you strumming the right strings, the correct ones for the chords, then it sounds okay. Then the pre-chorus is E minor, D, G, C, C, D, G, C, C, D. If you memorise that, it'll be easier. Then you're not looking backwards and forwards from your fingers to the sheet. So I try and memorise those chords, which quite a few of you have done. And then the chorus is the same as the verse. Verse 2 is the same chords again, G, C, E minor, D, same throughout until you get to the bridge. And the bridge is where the chorus is going fast and suddenly the music slows down for the bridge and it stops. And you get on an E minor chord really quickly at that point. And this part, the bridge, just make a mental note of this, that you need to go E minor, C, G, D. So after that chorus, you're going around, going for it, G, C, minor, D. Suddenly, it's the bridge, and you've got to slam on E minor when it goes quiet. And watch those chords, and try and count 5 times if you can. And then, when it comes back to the verse, it's the same chords. We've been doing the same pattern. We've been doing all through the popular one. All right. So, let's take it away with Ed Sheeran, and if you remember, there are 16 beats in, so we'll count 16 drum beats, okay? Ed Sheeran will be very proud. D. So this is the bridge. E minor second time bridge. C. G. D. E minor third time. C. G. D. E minor. C. G. D. Cool, brilliant, well done. So keep practicing that one, well done, keep going. So our next one is Paradise. So if we get our capo ready on capo 4, we're going to do Paradise by George Ezra. Hello everyone again, we're going to play Paradise by George Ezra. This one's got the A minor chord in that we're playing, C, first finger on, and second and third finger, that's it, A minor, five strings, and the last part is the hardest. We have to just know where we're going first, so if we read through it first, and then you digest it a bit, go over it yourselves, then you'll feel confident where you're going to, because it's quite easy to get very lost in this song. I've got to tell you though, boys and girls, I am missing the smell of break in the morning and the lunchtime, the smell of lunch coming through to the rooms I teach in. Missing that, but missing you more than ever. Obviously, I'm missing more the pupils, but the food is second. Anyway, we are going to look at the pre-chorus. The first bit isn't too bad. And then the pre-chorus is the first two lines. And at the end of those two lines, it says repeat. So we repeat just those two lines of the pre-chorus. We don't repeat the whole thing. So just those two lines, then the chorus, two lines. And then we just repeat the chorus, two lines. It's okay. And then we do G, A minor, C, two, three, four. That was a little instrumental part, very tiny. Just about three bars, G, A minor, C, and then it's on to verse two. And after verse two, it's pre-chorus, then the chorus. Remember, we're repeating those two lines each time. And then, I won't mention names, but some of you really like this instrumental part. I can think of some children at Longton schools and some in Chorley, really, really like this one. When it goes G, A minor, C, two, three, four, G, A minor, C, two, three, four. There weren't any words on this part, and it does take you by surprise, but if you practiced it, you know where it comes, so you feel quite cool playing it. Then the last bridge at the end, you play G, Paradise, roll on, roll on, meet me there, roll on. Then you repeat the line again, that same one. And then we go to the second line with C chord, Paradise, that line. And then it says, repeat the above line once. So you just go back to G and play the first line again. And then the third line, E minor, Paradise, roll on, roll on. And then it says, repeat that same line. That's the last line. With G on, and then you go back to the chorus and back to the pre-chorus twice and then back to the chorus. There's a lot to take in there. But if you listen to the song, maybe, without playing your guitar first, a few times, listen to George Ezra singing it, and go through it, watch where you're going to, that will get you used to where to go. So that takes a bit of practicing itself without even playing your guitar. Right, here we go. If you're ready, let's get George on. I'm going to put my glasses on, seeing this is our last one for this video. Till next week, we'll be doing another one for next week with some new songs. Here we go. Come on, George.
My love.
Everybody, so I'll do another video for next week, put some new songs on, and do some more finger picking. Maybe put some Billie Eilish on, Bad Guy. I'm actually doing another video for year six, that will be probably, it will have Bad Guy on definitely. Have some rock chords on, so if you wanted to have a look at it, some of the year fives, do a little bit extra, that's great. Feel free, and look forward to seeing you all very, very soon. Please keep practicing. Show your mums and dads, show your family, FaceTime your grandparents, cheer them up, put this on, sing for them. And remember, music brings a lot of happiness, hopefully, to a lot of people. So keep it up, everybody. Thank you and take care. See you next week. Bye.